to ourselves before you. Here we are in your presence, lifting holy hands to you. Here we are praising Jesus for all the things he's brought us through. Here we are, here we are in your presence, lifting holy hands to you.
Jesus, Jesus.
changed just to know you and to live to see your beauty and your grace. Heaven and earth cry out your name. Nations rise up and see your face.
Loving kindness.
is better than life. Thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall praise thee, thus will I bless thee. Thy kindness is better than life. Thy loving kindness is better than life. Thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall praise thee, thus will I bless thee. Is better than life. I lift up my hands in thy name. I lift up my hands in thy name. My lips shall praise thee, thus will I bless thee.
The Lord has been good to us. And in another dispensation, we'd say, we're glad. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Today is a special day on the journey of perfection. God has given us that perfect seed, and He has given us a roadmap where we walk from glory to glory to glory. And last week we had a lesson. And the week before we had a lesson, and this week we have a brand new word from the Lord. Have you done your homework? I hope you did, because exam time is coming. And the exam is live. So the AWC family, we're here to sharpen up ourselves and get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Hallelujah. A divine intervention is on its way. A divine intervention is always occurring because we establish our dependency 100% on the Lord God Almighty. Today, we are looking forward to a brand new experience in God. And I am encouraging persons who are not physically here at the UWI, Biology Lecture Theatre. If you are at home, I was going to say pretend, but be in church. If you are in your living room, put on your clothes. Right? Don't just drag yourself out of bed and say, all right, I'm going to just turn on Zoom or Facebook Live. Put on your clothes. Dress up like you're going to church. Amen? And if you're in your living room and we're singing, stand up and sing. Hold your hand up in the air and praise the Lord. I'm encouraging those who are at the unit to do the same. Hallelujah. Let it be that you are totally, totally engulfed in praise and worship today. Because the experience will not be meaningful unless you give your 100. If you're giving 25, expect that you will get above that in return. So at the end of the session, at the end of the time that we're having here, if you give your 100%, you are going to get pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Hallelujah. We also invite you to give your best offering, to sow a seed into the ministry. At the end of the sea, we are committed to helping people in Jesus' name, not only through preaching, but we also physically care for persons in our community, not only our congregation. So we're inviting you to sow a seed into this ministry. You can go online and transfer to account 5500985218 at Sagicor Bank in New Kingston, Jamaica. It's a business or checking account. Let us hear the testimonies. We're on Facebook Live, we're on Instagram Live, we're on YouTube Live, we're on Zoom. We are just live. Anywhere you want to find us, we're dead. Hallelujah. So get ready for worship at another level. Hallelujah. Right now I invite Evangelist Debbie Brown to come and minister in a special way. Evangelist Debbie Brown is someone who is experienced in interpreting the mind of Christ in sign. The Lord bless you as we worship Him in spirit and in truth.
I face all I say. your peace, Lord, I will rest. Oh my God, you are the best. I want you, Lord, and nothing less. If you say run, Lord, I will run. If you say no, then I won't. Before I make my next move, Lord, I will wait on you. If you say walk, Lord, I will walk. If you say push, I won't give in. Before I make my next move, Lord, I will wait. If you say run, Lord, I will run. If you say no, then I won't. Before I make my next move, Lord, I will wait on you. If you say walk, Lord, I will walk. If you say push, I won't give in. Before I make my next move, Lord, I will wait on you. Lord, I will wait on you. Lord,
Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's stable hands. A higher plane than I have found. Lord, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Hallelujah. There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is the Spirit, He brings that fire, ignites your candle and makes it whole. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Go light your world. Frustrated brother, see how he's trying to light his own candle some other way. See how your sister, she's been robbed and lied to, still holds without a flame. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the helpless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. So carry your candle around to the darkness. Seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. Take your candle and go light your world. Hallelujah.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Blessed
be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you, Almighty God. Father in heaven, how we love you. We lift your name in all the earth, Lord God. We thank you, Mighty God, that you are the light, O Lord, of this world. And we thank you, Lord God, that as you shine, Lord God, even so you shine your light into darkness, Almighty God. And we thank you, Lord God, that indeed, as you have shone your light, Almighty God, you have illuminated many of us, Mighty God, to see, Lord God, exactly, oh Lord God, the very God of all creation, the Lord God of all grace. We thank you this morning. We thank you, Mighty God, and we lift our hands in praises and worship you with all our hearts, Lord God. We want to thank you, Mighty God, for this is your will concerning us in Christ Jesus, that we give thanks unto you always. We thank you for this moment. We thank you that you are the God, Almighty God, that engineered the circumstances, Mighty God. And indeed, Lord, we thank you for this time. We thank you, Mighty God, even when we see things happening all around us. But we want to say thanks to you, Almighty God, for you are in total control. You know everything that is going on. You see and you understand, Almighty God. And we want to tell you thanks because we are assured, Almighty God, of your covering. We thank you this day right now, Lord. Even as we commit, Lord God, this time before you, Lord, we want to put, Lord God, new norms that are happening, Lord God, all around us, Mighty God, because of what is happening, Mighty God. New norms, Mighty God, become the order of the day, Lord God. But we know that there are many persons who are adverse, Lord God, to any kind of change, Lord God, adverse to all the different things that are happening, Mighty God. But we are praying, Lord God, that you will still their fears right now in the name of Jesus. We pray that you will still fears, Mighty God, and the worry, Mighty God. Still, Mighty God, the waters, Lord God. Oh, Lord God, for you are the God who walk upon the water. Oh, and you speak peace, be still, Lord God, and we say thanks, Lord God, for who you are at this moment. We thank you, Lord, that even as new norms are the order of the day, Lord God, in our land and in our world, Mighty God, we look to you and we see you saying even greater, Mighty God, that even you, Lord God, you are the God who, Lord God, institute and put things in place, Mighty God, and you have new norms, Mighty God, for every day, Lord God, is a new day, and with every day come new blessings, Mighty God. You declare with your word, Lord God, that behold, you will do a new thing, Mighty God. Shall it not spring forth, O Lord God? Shall we not know it, O Mighty God? You will make ways, Lord God, in the wilderness, Mighty God, and you will make rivers and streams in the desert, Lord God. And indeed, Lord God, they will blossom and bear, Mighty God, and there will be fruitfulness in the time of new norms, Mighty God. We are praying, Lord God, for education system. We are praying, Mighty God, for our conditions of our workplaces, Mighty God. We know the new norms affect all these places, Lord. But we are praying, Mighty God, in a particular way, Lord God, even where our education system is concerned, that, oh God, indeed, as these new norms norms are in place, mighty God. So you will give wisdom, mighty God. So you will give the instruction, mighty God, of those, Lord God, who are in charge, Lord God. That indeed they will put things in place according to the wisdom, oh God, and the purpose of God. So they will put things in place, mighty God, according to your purpose, Lord. You provide the necessary resources, Lord. Where there is lack, Lord God, that you will provide in those areas, mighty God, for both students and teachers, mighty God. We pray you make the way, Lord God, even in the workplaces, Lord, and all the things that may be set up, Lord God, to secure, mighty God, the people at work. We are praying, mighty God, that there will be measures, Lord God, that are godly. There will be measures, mighty God, that are for the smooth running, mighty God, of everyone, Lord God, that is involved. We want to say thank you, Lord God. We want to say thanks because in this time, we recognize, Lord God, that in this new norm, miraculous things will happen, mighty God. And so we speak into being right now that indeed miraculous will happen in every sector, in every area, mighty God, of our land, oh mighty God, that every part will be affected. In Jesus' name we pray and say thanks. In Jesus' name.
Blessed be the name of the Lord God of heaven. We worship and we continue to magnify your name, mighty God, for you alone are worthy to be praised and lifted up, and we worship all your holy name, Lord. We want to lift our voice, mighty God, to you. We want to lift, mighty God of heaven, our hearts to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, mighty God of heaven, in time past, how we have prayed, and how we have seen answers, mighty God of heaven. Oh, we have received your comfort in the name of Jesus Christ. And so we pray this morning, assured, mighty God, of your presence, assured of your answering to every individual in the name of Jesus Christ, of the comfort in the mighty name of Jesus. And so, God of heaven, I speak, mighty God, as I prophesy, in the name of Jesus Christ, for a sweet spirit upon this land, in the name of the Lord God of heaven, where they are distressed, mighty God, where they are fatigued, where they are, mighty God, are pain, I pray for the sweet spirit that will saturate the mind and heart of all people, and believe the cause, mighty God, they will be speaking, mighty God, words, oh, sweet words, mighty God, of love, joy, and peace, they will be speaking of refreshing, they will be speaking of the newness as the day arises, mighty God, and as the day is new, we will be speaking of the newness in the name of Jesus Christ, as our country reopens, mighty God, as our country returns to a sense of normalcy, we pray, God, for the best minds to come forward in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray that they will not be sidetracked in the name of the Lord God, of heaven. We curse any plan that will seek to sidetrack the best minds, oh mighty God, in our land, in the name of Jesus Christ, but they will be installed in my boards, mighty God, and committees. Yes. They will be, mighty God, leading, mighty God, of heaven, meetings in the name of Jesus Christ. And you, mighty God, you in our land, we pray and we prophesy over every meeting, mighty God, that shall take place as we seek to reopen, mighty God of heaven, that our workers will not be sidetracked, and mighty God of heaven, dealing with, mighty God, will not be fear, but they will be paid, mighty God, according to their work, in the name of Jesus Christ. And we pray for the employers, mighty God of heaven, that they, mighty God, will recognize that they are positioned by you, whatever way they have reached that position. Oh God of heaven, they will be reminded this way that they are placed there by you in the name of Jesus Christ to take care of. And so we pray that you will provide for their employers in the name of Jesus Christ. You will make doors open for them, mighty God of heaven, in this time in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, mighty God of frontline workers, mighty God of heaven, they will have resources, mighty God, to take care of their families. They will be able to live better, mighty God of heaven, as they seek to help the men and women and children of this country in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray, God of heaven, for a new day in our country. Oh, mighty God, as we pray, God of heaven, as they meet in the different board meetings and sessions, oh, mighty God, you will present yourself, Lord. Hallelujah. You will present yourself, oh, mighty God of heaven. And anything seen, mighty God of heaven, to cause, mighty God, any form of injustice, we come against it in the name of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ against any form or sheer of injustice. Oh, mighty God, in the planning there'll be fear trained. There will be fear trained. There will be fearless on the Lord and justice for our people in the name of Jesus Christ. As our country seeks, mighty God, to reopen and come back to a normality, mighty God, in the name of Jesus. We tell you thanks, mighty God, for the reward. We tell you thanks for the breakthrough. We tell you thanks for the healing. We tell you thanks for the comforting of heart in the name of Jesus Christ. And we glorify your name as we speak and prophesy to the winds of this country and the world. Oh, that the wind that blew upon us this day will cause us to be refreshed from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. Be refreshed in the name of Jesus Christ. And that sweet spirit will come forward out of every being in the name of Jesus. In every situation, in the name of the Lord God of heaven, we stamp your presence. And we pray, God of heaven, you will come forward out of every situation right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We glory and we honor you. We speak and we tell everyone to stand up and to worship the Lord God of heaven and jump to your feet. Oh, mighty God, some of you can't jump to your feet, but jump to your feet in spirit. Hallelujah! And worship the true and living God, for he is real. He is real. He is real. As I speak to you, as I prophesy this day, he will upon my life. We bless your name and we worship God.
The timeless theme, earth and heaven will pass away. It's not a dream. God will make all things new. That day, gone is the curse from which I stumbled and evil is banished to eternal hell. No more night, no more pain, no more tears, never cry. Chosen.
Uncertainty and sadness and not so wellness and all kind of things that is not at optimal. In the name of Jesus Christ, we recognize and we are pumping this energy to stand accurately in the banqueting house, mighty God of the Lord God of heaven. Noticing, mighty God, and recognizing that we are citizens of the kingdom of heaven. And we are receiving from your hand, Lord God, mercy and truth are met together, and righteousness and peace have kissed each other, and truth springs out of the earth, and righteousness agrees from heaven, and give a nod of notification that indeed, child of God is present. We will not try to light our own candles in confusion. We will not try, mighty God, to find strange lights, mighty God, to light our own candles. We will wait on you, Lord. We will wait on you. We will wait on you. We will wait on you. We will wait on you, mighty God. Passionately and aggressively, we will wait on you, mighty God. Not searching for someone to hear, to see if we can hurt the feeling of sadness. But we can do this in your name. In your name. We will wait on you, Lord. If you say wrong, then we run. If you say wait, we'll wait, my God. If you say no, we won't go. We'll wait on you, Lord. No candles shall be lit in our quarters by our own humanistic manipulations. Indeed, mighty God, we present ourselves before you. And we raise the standard of obedience, accuracy, my God, as we receive from your hand. Mercy and truth having prepared us. Righteousness and peace and love having done all of this. Thanks for your sanctifying portion as we break bread and stand, mighty God. Thank you, thank you. Thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ. Thank you for the body which was broken for us by your stripes. We are healed and transformed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thanks for more than our frail minds and imagination can capture. Thanks. Abu Rie. Sebeko Rianda Rababondorokis. Mabiandorokuria. Thanks for the language. Thanks for the peace. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, in like manner, as Jesus and we would have practiced oftentimes, we come to the table of the Lord and recognize who He is one more time as we receive the conscious realization of who we are one more time. And we reestablish our dependency on His Majesty. And anticipate the supernatural intervention and control. In obedience to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. As he said, as we do this, as often as we do this, anytime we do this, it's a note of remembrance that the work of salvation is complete. Jesus died, rose from the dead, rose triumphantly, led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. His standing awesomeness is there, in total obedience to His Majesty. And I say, eat ye, all of you. More of you, Lord. About all, what we need is more of you. More of you, Lord. More of you. He took the cup also. And he said to his disciples, "This is my blood, shed for the annihilation of sin, the canceling of sin, for every person that will receive." So we stand in His presence and practice our obedience one more time. As I say, in obedience to His Majesty. Thank you, all of you. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Wonderful, 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 wonderful. Wonderful Lord, wonderful Lord. Wonderful Jesus, true and kind. the Master. Amen. Your peace. Your peace, Lord. Your peace. Your peace, your peace, your peace, Lord. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Your peace. Today, ladies and gentlemen, I want to give God thanks for all my colleagues, all my co-workers, all my friends, entire company that helps to put together this program. Thanks to all the people who ministered so accurately. Thanks. The peace ambassador here, ladies and gentlemen, come to make sure that I stand in the place to encourage peace. But as I've said on many occasions, peace, state of mutual harmony between God and man, should first be encouraged within oneself. I know that things that look difficult and impossible poses challenges, and some people tend to not want to be partakers and participants in such. But I'm sure you have heard of the saying that adversity is the womb of invention. And as I've been saying to you, those of you who've been around me, you have a womb, but you need a birth, you need a seed. And I found failure to be the seed of invention. So you have the seed, you have the womb, you have a birth. But the womb and the seed seem trying and difficult. And from nothing, some people give up. Because I have nothing at all. But then let me remind you, ladies and gentlemen, that energy is here. Energy is here. Hallelujah. Rejoice in the Lord. Clap your hands and rejoice. And make a joyful noise unto the Lord. You are duped into thinking that we have to eat something, drink something, find something somewhere to make some energy. That's not how it is at all. And how it is at all. Energy is here. Desire and pump it in the right direction. You have it, bro. You have it. I read from the scriptures. I hear my brother Paul, the apostle, fellow apostle, a fellow apostle coming from hardships and difficulties and misunderstandings, and didn't know his brother from a bruise in relation to God. I know that many people like to hitch themselves to a cause and fight for it, and people are searching for people to hate because they think they should be on one side of people who don't seem to be thinking like them. And Saul was one such one who thought that he was righteous in destroying those who didn't seem to be so righteous. I looked at the faces of the used to be policemen, the murderers. George's murderers. And they had on prison clothes at the time the pictures were taken. I see no remorse in them. Why? Because they trust the system. They trust the system, that the system will not treat them too harsh. They trust the system that exists, that they might just get two taps on the hand. Huh? The justice system. Oh my God. These guys didn't just happen to be on the scene. Some of these terrorist situations and people started way back from youthful days. Prepare. Pilots that flew aircraft into the towers didn't just turn up at the airport and thought of mischief. They were trained to fly in the country that they were seeking to destroy. The rest of it. People have given themselves to destruction, stupidness, and satanic influence upon others. But I want to tell you that there are many voices crying from the grave, and blood that is crying from the earth. And even if there's no person, there's no human being to defend the cause, the way that God has established mankind, no one was unseen. And in this earthly house of this tabernacle that we are given to function, the deeds of our bodies are recorded. And I am not a pie in the sky kind of preacher. I get in the face of God and ask you questions. And I'm sure I have some adequate answers. Not a wasp just learning how to destroy people, but more of the bee-like quality that's working on the sweetness, working on the honey that will not only make my heart glad, but I can also help people in Jesus' name. So the peace ambassador at your service, ladies and gentlemen. Hallelujah. I was talking about my brother Saul, who before he was a brother, he thought that the brothers were off the rockers and they needed to be put down. And there are too many people who just taken things in their own hands and I believe I'm right. But I tell you this, those murderers are not on their own. They are not just, it's not just four of them. There's a whole barrage of people thinking in that direction. Can I say this? I don't worry about it. I'm a kingdom citizen now. I used to have to worry about them when I didn't know what the God was drinking. But now I know that for to me to live is Christ and to die is gain. When I'm dead or alive, whether I have Martin Luther or Al Sharpton or anybody to speak for me, Sam Sharp or Paul Vogel or anybody to speak for me, the Lord God of heaven made it possible that my remains cannot go unnoticed. My coming in was orchestrated by him, organized and established by him. My going out the same. And it's the same for you, whether you're a righteous man or an unrighteous man. We don't have to fight. I don't have to find you and kill you because you threaten me. He's ambassador to service, ladies and gentlemen. Romans chapter 7 24 and 25, you would have heard that sometime before. But I'm doing, I'm fixing the paradigm. I'm helping to fix the paradigm, not only for me, but for the people who listen to me. And one of the way, to fix the paradigm is to keep pumping the energy in the right direction. Hallelujah. The Apostle Paul, no, he wasn't Saul at the time that he was saying this. He would have been passed from that ugly life into this new life. And he would say that I find myself in a straight betwixt two. So he said, verse 24, O wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from the body of this death? And that is after he, before, you can read it at another time. But he had a build up to say, that which I would I do not, and that which I would not, that I do I want, this what I do that, my conscious mind say this, but I don't pop it into me, the subconscious and the body don't know what to do, and I am confused. But verse 25 he said, I thank God through Jesus Christ. Hear the light. At the end of the darkness. You might be experiencing darkness, says Lenny. It might be that you're experiencing a kind of darkness you've never seen before. And let me tell you, sometimes these darkness are inattributable. They come upon you when you have a little knowledge, a little learning. They come upon you sometimes when you think you have something and you're running with it and two steps down the road you find that you're in trouble, everything looks black and you don't know where to go because you thought you had it there just a while ago. You say, I'm going to do this. But you did not spend the requisite kind of time and energy to put things in perspective to get it righteous. The subconscious don't know what you're doing. So your whole system is still being manipulated by the soulless realm. And let me just say this up front here. So even if I don't remember, say it again, it could have been said. The spirit must be king. Wherever you are, please say it with me. The spirit must be king. So what we want to happen, I'm coaching it in a couple of times. What we want to happen is to have this receptacle within you, within me, so that I can receive the unhindered instructions from the Spirit of God. Now he can't do that. He can't just force my will and do that. I have to open the door. I have to let him. I am the owner of the yard. So I have to let him. I can give him the keys. Then he owns the yard and I live in there. Hallelujah. Don't need to worry. Make up your face and say, I'm going to do you this. That's your mind. That's your opinion. You think you own it and you think you make it. But I don't look after me. I wake up every day and submit again. I resubmit and resubmit. Fix my guard and pump it in. Get some energy in there. Christ war. So Paul saw something. He said, oh, I thank God through Jesus Christ, O Lord. There's light, illumination. Precious name of Jesus. Woo! So then, with the mind, I myself serve the Lord. And I want to interpret that. I decided that I agree with myself that I'm going to serve the Lord. It's my intention to always serve the Lord. But with the flesh, the law of sin, my soul is still giving me a run for the money because there are sinful actions that I'm guilty of. There are Philistines, there are Egyptians, there are all kinds of types and Hittites and Hivites and Perizzites, all kinds of angst that they're trying to grab me and put me back into prison. How do I get out of here? How do I get out of here? Well, the thing is that you notice that Jesus Christ, I thank Jesus Christ, I thank the Lord through Jesus Christ. Through Jesus Christ. Who is this Jesus Christ guy? Who is it? There are some questions. Some people ask them, who is this Jesus Christ guy? And they are confusing themselves. They are distracting them. So who is this Jesus Christ? He's God. He says God. Oh, yes. He's God. The Lord God. That's God. How did Jesus come to be God? Because the Lord God made this man and tabernacled himself in him. And the man by himself knew no sin. The man by himself had no guilt. So he pleased the Father. I'm calling some words and using some terms that he might not be acquainted with and be able to relate to. But the fact is that there's doubt. I have some, can share it with you. There are others who have some light that can share with you. But you have to pump the energy in the right direction. I need clarity. You have to cry out like Saul, like Paul. Well, when he was Saul, he said, what am I to do? What do I do now that I have kicked against the brick? I am down at the bottom of myself. I am here. The answer comes, rise and get you to the man that is at the straight street. You say, well, I don't need no help from no man. Yes, you do. And that's why God made Jesus. Yes, to be seen for us. A man helped man through Jesus Christ. Or should I say, God helped man through Jesus Christ. And that's why the man said, Jesus said, will thou be made whole? I don't know, you see Christ, yes, sir. And he said, I have no man to put me in. He wasn't too off when he was saying that. I have no man to put me in. But then he didn't recognize the man he was talking to. That's the man of men. To come and get man out of his prison. So some of us are looking at other men and we see men do and fall into difficulties and commit some things and do some things wrong. And we say, I'm not into this church business because I'm here hypocrite over there. So you're wrong. You're wrong because God has a man for you. And God is a man for you to help you to come out of that mess that you're in. If you don't pump some energy in the right direction, you may never find that man. Say, Lord, save me. And he'll send the man. Like a heat seeking missile. He'll find you right where you are. Yeah. Precious Jesus. Yeah. Now the Apostle Paul having found himself in this place now where he is really pumping some energy and getting some results and granted toss him, knock him up, whatever. He has it. He turns to the next chapter, Romans chapter 8. I love it with all my heart. Hallelujah. And I just read verse 1 and 2. The brother says, having had it, chapter 7. Having been there, seen that, done that. There is therefore right now. We don't have to fight, we don't have to fight, we don't have to war. There are some assurances that one can have. Oh yeah. You don't like somebody, you say, but I don't like church because I don't like him. You're stupid. He's not living right, so I'm not going to church. You're messing up the thing, man. You don't have to do that. You can step past everybody and anybody and find yourself in Jesus Christ and get your share. Pump the energy in finding Jesus Christ. Where is that? There is therefore right now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. And some of the people that you might be accusing, some of those people, they are in. So, but how come they are in and I know this and know that you don't know squat? Because what happens is that is that I remember once I had difficulties and I was really on my face before the Lord. And the Lord said, get up. He was talking to me. And this is his favorite guy. And he was telling me, get up. But God, I'm praying. Get up. I want to talk to you. He said, I didn't choose you because you were ready. I didn't come for you because you were perfect. No matter what, you were far from God. So if you're down there crying to me, you won't hear what I say. So get up. I just got up and stood up. I was listening. He said, I choose you because I see in you the heart that I can work with. You are mixed up, confused, full of foolishness. You give your Lord kind of mess. But I see a heart in you that I can work with. I can fix you. All you have to say is I. If you say I, then I will bring the pool from the fire of my eternalness, and I will place it upon your tongue and purge you and cleanse you and fix you beyond anything that you could imagine. You can't fix yourself, so get up. You're great. I heard you. Hallelujah! I heard you. I heard you crying and saying you don't know what to do. Oh, wretched man that I am, you say. You don't want to stay here, wretched. So get up. Get up and stand up. Stand on the word. And let me speak into your life. Hallelujah. Though you are as wretched as so and so, I interpret as God. White and black, I am who call it that, especially now. Though you are wretched and things have gone south and sideways, I am here to fix you. I don't have to relate it to any particular thing, but though you have been at the bottom and now I find one, I remember, you know, this good friend of mine from the scriptures, he said, I found myself at the bottom of hell. At the bottom of the mountain, at the bottom of the sea, and I cried unto the Lord. And he sent me salvation. Who went for him? A great white shark. A great white went for him. Oh yes. That was supposed to be the one that would destroy him, but that was his transportation to the shores of Nineveh. I don't know. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't tell you everything about my research in one shot. So you have to do some work for yourself. Don't just stand there and say, how comes you know? That's my responsibility. That's not my responsibility to prove to you whether how comes I know. I know. A great white shark went for Jonah, fetched him, and spat him out on the shores of Nineveh. Why? Because the servant of the Lord had some work to do. He needed transportation from the bottom of hell, from the depths of the sea. Nobody could go for him. A great white man for him. Nowhere. Great white. Hallelujah. Because people see big fish, they think it's weird. Great white. Put it at the worst. This is one that should have eaten him. Well, he took him through the similar process.
Yeah.
He swallowed it. Then I said, he or it, I don't know. I feel like saying he. Swallowed the servant of the Lord and kept him safe. Don't worry about the slime and everything else that he went through. All happens is that in a short while, he was on the shores of Nineveh, on the sand and ready. Well, that's not a stone, I don't know. And ready to take on anyway. That message was one of the greatest messages ever preached. He covered the distance in the shortest time that could be done. And he got the message across. And the people, the ungodly people of Nineveh, they repented. Mission accomplished, people say. Amen. Amen. Romans chapter 8. Verses 1 and 2. There is therefore now, right now, no condemnation to the people of Nineveh. Hello, hello, hello. Therefore, right now, no condemnation for anybody who has decided, I want Jesus, I repent, and I want help, and God's gonna find help and send for it. A man called Jonah. A man called Jonah, who was just a while ago in rebellion. Well, he and God sorted out themselves. I'm full of it. I'm excited. He and God sorted out themselves, and God said, you've made a mess of things, but you are still my servant. I purge and purify you, though you go preach. But some people couldn't work with that because they don't want nothing to do with anybody who look like they are not working. You know? Well, I'm sorry, if I would probably turn over your car. I might turn some people against me when I say this. But I don't think it's a color problem. I think it's a heart problem. There are white men and women who would not have killed George Floyd.
That's right.
And there are black men who would have.
Yes,
sir. It's a heart condition. I know that some of you are waiting. I know that some people, not you, them, are waiting for some, looking for people to hear, because I might be adding to the list, but I tell you, I have evidence. Strong evidence. And somebody might call me a whitey, I don't care. I say that I know, I have seen, it's all over the place that the white murderers did terrible things. But I tell you, one of the things why they did it is because they know that the system would be kind to them. And they know how the black people were going to react. So they could get a chance to punish some more black people. Because you don't hear some of the stories of some of the, what's happening to some of the other black people. There are many black people who nobody had nobody cameras, nobody had no cell phones, and nobody had no, you understand?
Yes.
But ladies and gentlemen, there are some at home. And I tell you this, then, when I speak, nobody better even think about coming my way. But I see you about Apostle God of Christ. I'm not just that. I'm a kingdom citizen. Can't touch this. This is the day that we need for people, black, white, whatever, to stand up and ring the bell of victory. Oops. Oops, I hear I see another set of warriors coming at me because I'm ringing the bell. Oh my God. People are always trying to find reasons to hate people and whatever. I don't care. You can hate me if you want, but I don't hate you. Listen, ladies and gentlemen. We have put down many people. We have put down many people in this country. Not put down by white men. Not white people killing the youth on our streets. You say, but they are criminals and they are this and they are that. How do you know? We have the law that is supposed to run them through. And just like all those murderers didn't allow the law to take its course. So we have some people here don't do that either.
That's right.
But as one black man was asking in a particular forum, Where are the guns? Where are the knives? Where are those people who they fight one another? They fight black fighting black. They have gangs fighting one another. Where are they when the white man kills black man? Not inciting, and I'm saying just as you said, not inciting any violence. But don't tell me that this is a color thing. People have found themselves causes to be haters of other people because of all kinds of things. Color, creed, race, all kinds of things. And there are some people who are religiously as cruel and worse. Why is it that a man who's tricked up would what's the word? Why is it that a man would put on a bomb? knowing that he was going to go with that and press the trigger when he comes into populated space. Because he feels like there is some God somewhere who will be pleased when he does that. I'm not preaching that as you. I'm preaching destroying people so that you can make and promote a cause. I'm saying Jesus Christ came to save lives. Save souls, save lives, save people. He didn't have to kill nobody else. He went and he took on death. He took on sin, and walked through the portals of death. I remember one time somebody asked me, but why did he have to die? That's a bloodshed kind of Christianity this you worship. You are the wrong thing, I said to him. You are off being completely, you are out of sync. Because it wasn't God that was, you know, punishing Manuel. No. God tabernacled himself in Christ. And went and took on sin. Death was an employee of the same God who was going through that process. That is the process. That's how you go through cessation of life and go through. That is how you die. And he implied death, saying, "Now you kill me, because I'm the only one who can redeem mankind. Yeah. I'm the only one who can cause salvation." Death wasn't doing anything wrong. But it killed Jesus. The matter of fact, the man said it. He said, "No one taken my life from me. I laid down on myself and I take it up back. Read the Bible and pray and ask God for illumination. Light is in the place. You don't have to get confused and bewildered. It doesn't take a misguided person to hold a man down. This is not just shooting him. Hold him down. Know that is what they are doing. The four of them, especially the other three, not the one standing up or doing, is going to cause his death. And you just did it. And you waited on the time for that one. That is not just that. I tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. Black people need to recognize that we don't need no permission from white people to breathe. You don't have to take your foot off the neck for me to breathe. And as I say that, I say also that black people don't need no permission from black people either to breathe. We can do this with a heart change. We have been having the message being preached to us, preached all around us for many years, and sometimes get compromised because people can't see the difference between their culture and the culture of the people they are supposed to preach to. I've been there, ladies and gentlemen, I've seen operation. I've seen people because of their ethnic background, the culture, because of their practices, because of their wealth or the lack of it, people get treated differently. It's time the righteous church stand up. Amen. Speak up. It's a hard condition, ladies and gentlemen. It's a hard condition. Now don't just curse yourself and done. Don't just say, "Oh, wretched man that I am, I'm done." For the law of the Spirit, verse 2 of chapter 8, "For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death." Hallelujah. It's more than what meets the eye. For the Lord Jesus Christ has come to purge and deliver. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Set your will. Set your will. Right your will. Come on, come on. You need to write this down. Set your will, write your will, and constantly give it the requisite energy to be realized. Right before your very eyes. You don't have to bring energy from anywhere. You be right there with you. You just give that energy. How do you do that? Your desire. Your desire. Desire. Well. The statement ever since the Lord revealed it to me has been, it has been pumped to different levels in recent times. Desire well. Pump the necessary energy. Pull that trigger. Desire, ladies and gentlemen, is that trigger. For whoever, for whatever needs to be put in place to become whoever you must be. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you to write this down wherever you are. Really write this down. I believe writing and reading and writing are the greatest form of retention, you know. And I think that that's a way how you can build your paradigm. Make a habit of it. That is done. To build your paradigm, you need to make a habit of the righteous things that you pump into your subconscious. Write it down how you can. And I'll forgive you for backing. You write it down how you can, right? So you build a habit. Now I'm suggesting that a part of that desiring well, you need to have a conversation with His Majesty King Jesus. And invite Him to come into your heart. Say, Lord, I beseech thee. Now that is not just a one-shot thing. You need to constantly pump it. So you develop a habit of righteous thoughts and righteous actions. Employ best practices. Pumping it in. Of a righteous desire. Desire well. Hallelujah. Because I tell you why. Write this down. We are going to constantly think thoughts that are in harmony with our body. We are, however you put it, we are constant. All our thoughts are going to be coming as a result of the harmony with your body. So in this case, harmony may not be necessarily a good word.
Yeah.
Because it means you come into agreement with the thoughts that you think, your reflex action, the thoughts that flow from you and easily are coming from your body. So you're going to constantly think thoughts that are in harmony with your body. Hallelujah. Again, I say, you don't have to. You don't have to try to light your candle by yourself. You can wait on the Lord. Now I have a big suggestion. Give yourself a raise. Woo! Give yourself a raise. Lift yourself to the next level. Or even beyond. How am I suggesting you do that? Praise yourself and celebrate. Praise yourself, ladies and gentlemen. I'm ready to give them some. Yourself and celebrate. Let's take a moment to do it. Everybody be standing on your feet and rejoicing. Praise yourself and celebrate. You are busy here, don't you? You have accomplished something. You have accomplished something. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Clap it up for victory, everybody. You know, I'm going to tell you something to make this as accurate as I can. Praise yourself. Give yourself a raise. Praise yourself. You say, but sir, however, you don't know what, as a servant of the Lord, Isaiah was having a chat with God, and God was seeking to get him to perform an act of helping people in Jesus' name. And Isaiah said, oh, you don't know me, though. It's obvious you don't know me. I am a man who questions father, and I am a man from a set of people who cause them fair share too. I'm a man of unclean lips, and I come from background of that. You know, it's not me wrong, and God said, you are one. As he was about to say the next thing, God said, shut up. And he said to me, stand up and say, open your mouth and allow me to purge you. Hallelujah. So here I am saying this, I ask this part of it. I'm saying, you have to constantly, I'm not going to say it on a daily basis, regularly as is necessary. Huh? Do a little audit of yourself. And the few unfortunate kerfuffles and mix up, forgive those. Rid yourself of those maladies that comes from time to time, like Egyptians seeking to bring you back to Egypt. You say, but then, sir, there's a Red Sea in front of you. Well, this is what we're going to do now. This is how we get rid of the Red Sea. You remember what the Lord said to his servants? He said, what's that you have in your hand? A piece of dry skin. Well, in order to get rid of the Red Sea, you have to give yourself a lift, give yourself a raise. Eh? So you praise yourself, building the confidence, and celebrate. Eh? You know what comes as a result of that celebration? The experience, the tangible manifestation of the miraculous. It's waiting for you to give yourself a raise, praise yourself, and celebrate. Yes. And watch the miraculous. Surprise yourself. You don't even know. But you need to show what God is going to do. You just praise yourself. Huh? As I said, you start this way. In case you're tempted to go back to Egypt, you think about it. Do the audit of yourself. Some unfortunate things will come up. You forgive yourself of the unfortunate few things. Yes. You don't have much time for that. Yes. You have to spend the time giving yourself a raise. Yes. You have to spend the time praising yourself. Really look at the paper, you write it down and say, why are you being well at the same? See, you don't think that was good, boy. Hey, big up yourself and celebrate. Find a real celebrate. Yes. Oh, I'm going to check this. Work hard for your 15%. Yeah? Because you're going to need it to celebrate. Yeah. Work hard for your 5% because you're going to need it to give alms and to be delivered. Amen. Work hard for your 15%. I'm talking about off your income.
Yes.
Because you're going to need it to celebrate. Celebrate, ladies and gentlemen, whether you think you have it or not. Because at the end of that, what comes as a result of your celebration is the tangible manifestation of the presence of God. And the miraculous is sweet. When the miraculous comes, baby, you don't need nobody to encourage you. When the miraculous comes, you are going to be in heavenly places. You have a new paradigm from which to think thoughts from. Glory, hallelujah! Rejoice with me, ladies and gentlemen. Rejoice! Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we tell you thanks. Tell you thanks to all the people, mighty God, struggling to find the right way to choose. Oh, my God, I tell you, remind people, Lord, of mercy that we'll be able to rewrite their lives if we allow you in. Father, for every home represented here, we pray, my God, that the illuminating power of God will be experienced. Let your name be glorified. Let God arise. Let God arise and your enemies are scattered. We rejoice in learning and celebrate in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Clap your hands and rejoice, ladies and gentlemen. God bless you. Peace be upon you.
Upon God, He's gonna come through over and over and over and over again. Right? Hallelujah. One thing I want to encourage us all is to have a very vivid imagination. See yourself driving that Porsche. Right? See yourself diving into that pool in the backyard. See yourself standing and speaking to hundreds and thousands and millions of persons, impacting life, and worship God even now. Hallelujah. God is not restricted to time, so we're celebrating Jesus. Here at Apostolic Worship Center, we encourage worship on the Word. And as we have received from the Lord through His servant, Senior Apostle Dr. Selvin George Watson, we give God thanks. We give God thanks for His servant. We give God thanks for Him giving Himself to looking into the face of the Lord and coming up with the authentic and accurate Word of God for the moment. We give God thanks. I want to encourage all of us now to be like that man in Psalm 1. And what I meant. Meditate on the Word of God. You have taken notes? When you wake up in the morning, open your notes, what a mess. You break for lunch, what a mess. Rewatch a video, we are on Facebook Live, go back and watch a video. Instagram stories will have a recording of today's service. Watch it again, spend some time. Take 15 minutes out of your lunch break just to what a mess. Amen? Because it is a habit that we need to create so our subconscious mind will do what it needs to do to get us to our goal. What a mess. What we say? What a mess. Play the audio in your car. Put in your ears when you're at work and you listen. Rewatch your videos. Did I say that? Watch your videos again. On YouTube Live. Alright? What a mess. Because what we constantly feed into our conscious mind will become a permanent part of our subconscious. Amen. I told you that we're going to get a new word and message today. Don't fail the exam. Exam starts right away. And God has already given us the winner mentality. I invite everyone to sow into the ministry. Give your best offering. If you're not physically here at the University of the West Indies Biology Lecture Theatre, I welcome and encourage you to sow through our bank account at Sagicor Bank, New Kingston, Dominica Drive. Account number 5500985218. Help us to help people in Jesus' name. We are celebrating this week a number of members of our congregation on birthdays. Tomorrow, Lonnie in Canada. Alright, happy birthday, Lonnie, tomorrow. And I hear that Auntie Sylvia have a birthday Wednesday. Happy birthday to Sylvia on Wednesday. And Debbie Brown, I saw her earlier, she's here. Happy birthday! We're celebrating on Thursday with Debbie. What a week, because on Friday, somebody have an anniversary, Uncle Sean? You have an anniversary? Auntie Polly and Uncle Sean, they have, is it the 22nd? 21st anniversary to Uncle Sean and to Polly on Friday. Celebrate, work hard for 50%, and give yourself a raise. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you peace. Bless you.